So we're going back to our scripture that we used last Sunday, Philippians chapter 3, 13 and 14. Last week we were focused on not looking back. Paul said that forgetting what lies behind. But today our focus is looking forward. Keep your eyes on Christ, or the goal is the message for today. So let's read Philippians chapter 3, 13 to 14. It says, brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead. Straining. I press on toward a goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. You know, studying about Paul and his writings, I think that the Apostle Paul loves sports. I mean, just look at his writings and he uses. I believe that he probably used to go to sports events and maybe even watch the Olympics. The Olympics have been around for so long. So he used us. He uses sports or athletes as a metaphor for Christian life. Just look at 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24. He likens Christians to marathon runners. He said in verse 24, 1 Corinthians chapter 9, do you not know that in a race all the runners run? But only one gets the prize, runs in such a way to get the prize. And also in verse 26 of the same chapter, he said, I do not run like someone running aimlessly. I do not fight like a boxer beating the air. And there's another one in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5. He says, similarly, anyone who competes as an athlete does not receive the victor's crown except by competing according to the rules. So, you know, the Apostle Paul was a person who loved sports. Well, I have to admit, I'm not really into so much sports. I'm not a serious fan of any team or sports. I do watch sports, especially if they're winning. I like to watch them, but I don't really follow what's going on. Growing up, I didn't play any sports or league. I played a little bit of basketball, and that's about it. I'm not good in any sports. Several years ago, I think 2005, I had a chance to play golf. Can you imagine me playing golf? And what happened was, we had our international convention here in Sacramento, and I was the one who was putting it together. And some of our pastors, they love to play golf. And specifically Pastor Paul Parker in Hawaii requested that we should have some relaxing or rest moment during the convention, a break from the convention, and play golf. And And so I agreed and then I put it on the schedule. And so we served over here in Gerber and Roger, somewhere around there. I don't know, it's a hawk, something. Wild hawk. Okay. It's a wild hawk. So, anyway, they invited me to join. And it was the first time I stepped on a golf course. It was my first time to hold a golf club. And I did not know, and I said, do not know what the rules are. But I went there, and they told me that golf is a very relaxing game. Is that true, John plays golf. They told me that it's a very relaxing, stress reliever sport. But I found out it was the other way around. I mean, after you took a swing at the ball and you don't hit it, it's frustrating. You know, you hit the ball and you swing and you don't hit it, the ball stays there. Only the grass flies. Not only that, when I finally hit the ball, instead of putting it closer to the hole, it goes 2 miles away from the hole. It was a frustrating game. And like I said, I played basketball, a little bit of basketball, but I'm not good at it either. Every time I stick the ball, it doesn't even hit the rim or the board. So, you see my sports ability now. And in fact, fishing. Yeah, this was long time ago, fishing. We were in Hawaii in Turtle Bay. You know where Turtle Bay is? They call it Turtle Bay because there's a lot of turtles. And there's a rock, and you stand there and you just throw your fishing line. And I was with my brother-in-law, and he was 10 feet away from me. Every time he throws his line in the water, he catches a fish. Every time I throw my line in the water, nothing. Not even a bite. And so finally I said, when you get a bite, hand me your fishing rod and then I'll pretend I'll catch it. But I stood there. Caught nothing at all. So you see how my sports ability, where I stand. But I believe that I can be better. I can do much better in any sport if they allow me to change the rules. Amen. I mean, do you love me to change the rules when it comes to golfing? Because, you know, for me, I will take away the hole and just take a swing at the ball, and wherever the ball goes, they'll say, give me a point. Or basketball, you know, I just shoot the ball anywhere without, you know, you don't need to have a goal there or the board or the rim. And I just shoot it, and anywhere, then I get a 3 points. I think I can do better. or they can change the rule of fishing. For as long as I throw the line into the water, I should get a point. But unfortunately, it doesn't work that way. In sport, there are rules to follow and a goal to hit. Paul understood the principles in winning. Again, he said in 1 and 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5, so similarly, anyone who competes as an athlete does not receive the victor's reward or the victor's crown except by competing according to the rules. No hope for me when it comes to sports. You cannot change the rules. Today, we're going to look at three very important things that leads to a victor's crown. How do we get the victor's crown or to hit the goal or to hit the prize? So I'm going to give you three important things. And the first one is the importance of having a goal. It's very important to have a goal. Second, the role of rules. And the third point is keep your eyes on the prize or the goal. The importance of having a goal. Again, 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 26, Paul said, therefore I do not run like someone running aimlessly. I do not fight like a boxer beating the air. So, not having a goal is like chicken running around without a head. Or like Pacquiao getting into the ring without an opponent. There is always a goal. And that is very important. In order for someone to claim victory, to claim the prize, you must have a goal. I read some articles online on why it is necessary to set a goal. They give a lot of good reasons, but let me just give you a few. I think they're very important, whatever reasons that they give why it's necessary to have a goal. It is very important that there's so much things that they gave. So I just give you three today. First of all, a goal provides the clarity of direction. It is very important for us to have a goal in life. It's very important for us to have a goal, I mean, like for this year 2023. What are your goals? Do we just, start the year without and just let things happen? It is very important to have a goal for us to claim, for anyone to claim victory, you must have a goal. Now, there's nothing more frustrating or exhausting than doing something without knowing what it leads you to. It is exhausting. It is frustrating when you're doing something without knowing why you're doing it to begin with. When you get on a plane and they will tell you to listen to the instruction for safety, they tell you how to put your seatbelt and how to put on the oxygen mask. How many of you listen to that? I don't. I don't really listen to that. Okay? I don't pay attention. But there is one thing, the announcement that they do that I carefully listen to. When they say that the door is now closed and this flight is flight 747 and it's going to, That I miss it. If I'm going to Honolulu, when they make that announcement, I want to hear them to say, we're going to Honolulu. Because that is very important. Because I want to hear them say that, because I don't want to end up in New York like Kevin in the Home Alone movie. But most people are like Kevin, lost in New York without clarity of direction. Just get on the plane and, you know, he was lost. And so there are many people that go through life. We go to the new year or the year without a goal. Again, it's like getting on a plane without knowing where the plane will take them. At the end of the day, you feel, or they have the sense of failure because they have not accomplished anything, because they have not set a goal. You know, the feeling that you get to the end of the year and you feel like you're such a failure because you have not accomplished anything. Maybe the reason why is that you have not set a goal for yourself. You have not set a goal for you to accomplish. So, set a goal is very important. If in order for you to claim victory, in order for anyone to claim victory or have a sense of accomplishment, you need to have a goal. Set a goal for your life. Second, a goal provides purpose to every decision and action. Let me repeat that. Goal provides purpose to every decision and action that you make. This is really a time and energy saver, because every decision and action you make has a purpose, and the purpose is towards that goal. You don't just make decisions and do things without knowing what direction or where you're going. It's like the Apostle Paul. When we study the life of the Apostle Paul in the book of Acts, we learn that he set goals for himself. One of the goals that he set for himself was that he was going to Jerusalem. Remember that story there in the book of Acts? He said he was going to Jerusalem. That was his goal. That was the price that he set for himself. He was going to Jerusalem. So, in spite of several warnings that for him not to go to, because it's going to put his life in danger, yet his decisions and actions purpose is to go to Jerusalem. In other words, you put your energy towards the actions and decisions that you make towards that goal. You don't just waste your energy and your time doing things without a purpose. So it's very important that we set a goal for ourselves. The third thing that I have here that why it is important to set a goal for ourselves is because Jesus himself set a goal. It's not a bad thing, or it's not a sin, or it's not evil to set a goal for ourselves, because Jesus himself set some goals. When he called his disciples, he did not just tell them, come follow and we'll just hang around. You'll hang out. Remember that time when Jesus called his disciple Peter and his brother? Jesus said, come follow me. That was the call. The goal was, I will make you fishers of men. So even Jesus set goals, and he even set goals for the church. Matthew chapter 28, Jesus set the goal for the church, and the goal is that go into all the world and preach the gospel. So Jesus set the goal for himself, but he told us the reason why he came. He said, I came that you may have life, and to have it to the full. So that was the goal that Jesus set for himself. And that goal took him all the way to the cross. And when he was hanging on the cross, there was this sense of accomplishment when he said, it is finished. So, even Jesus and why he came here to earth, he set a goal, and the goal was to give us freedom and to set us free and to give us life, and then that goal took him all the way to the cross. And while he was hanging on the cross, there was a sense of accomplishment, or he announced that it is finished. So without a goal, Jesus could not have said, it is finished. But because there was a goal, there was a price, there was a purpose, there was a destination that he set for himself. So when he finally arrived there, he said, it is finished. See, that tells us of how important it is for us to set goals for ourselves. Our church, we set goals for ourselves, goal for our church. Our mission statement says that. Our mission statement is what it says. Anybody know? To bring people to Christ into a relationship with Christ, equip them, make the same difference in the lives of others. So there is a goal. When you have a business, you set goals. And again, it is very important because every decision that you make, every action that you take will be towards to accomplish that goal. You're not just wasting your time, you're not just striking anywhere and do whatever you want to do without a goal or a set of purpose or destination. Goal is important. Make sure to set one for yourself in 2022. Second point that I have is the role of rules. Again, Paul said to get the victor strong, one must play by the rules. There are several reasons why rules are an important part of sports. There are some that I found. Rules provide guidelines on how the game is played. It provides fair and honest competition. It provides safety of the players. No rules equals chaos. So, that is the role of rules. That's why they say, that's what they say. Okay, that rules provides guidelines, fair and honest competition, safety of the players, rules of chaos. But I say, rules makes it hard to play the game. Rules make it hard to accomplish your goal. So, it is not just providing safety for the players, but rules for the game. For me, it makes it hard to play the game. It makes it hard to accomplish your goal. Like, for example, the game of golf. Why is it that they make it so hard to play the sport? Why do they have to plant trees there? Why do they have to have bushes? Why do they have to have a pond? Why do they have to have the, I don't know what they call it, where they put the sand? What is it? Sand traps? That's why it's called traps. Why? Why play on the grass? Okay. Why do you plant trees there and just to put some obstacles? Why do you make the hole for the golf too small? Why don't they make it? Why don't they make it a crater? Right? Why play on the grass? Why not on a smooth surface? Again, why put a pond there and a sand trap? Why make it too hard? In basketball, why do you have to dribble the ball? Why can't we just carry the ball and run with it and shoot it? Why do you have to guard the shooter? Why do you make the ring too small? Why not again make it bigger? So rules in general don't make it easy, but it makes it hard to make the goal. Okay? Makes it hard to make the goal. The rules are there to put us an obstacle, but it is this obstacle that created stars in sports. It is the hardship of the rules that made Michael Jordan a star. It is the trees and the bushes and the ponds and the sand traps and the grass that made Tiger Woods Tiger Woods. In football, it is the rules, the hardship, or the hard part of the rules that made Tom Brady the GOAT, or the greatest of all time. Somehow they found a way to overcome the hardship of the rules that made them tough and made them better. This is the problem, he said, to get the victor's crown is to compete according to the rules. So many people today are afraid to set goals for themselves because it's difficult. The way to get to your goal or to your prize is difficult. It's not an easy road to travel. Paul himself was very familiar with hardship. He endured every single day when he was stoned, he was arrested, he was drugged, he was in prison. But it was those difficult experiences in life that made him tough and better. So do not be afraid when it comes to the roles that you want to play to get to your goal or to get the prize, because it will make you better. I don't think there will be a Michael Jordan if they just have to carry the ball and run with it. It is the tough, hard rules that makes people bend. So they find some ways to overcome the hardship. And that's what makes them bend. So keep in mind, when you set a rule for yourself, again, this is very important to set a rule for yourself. Do not be afraid of the rules or how to get them, because in the process, it will make you much better person. And make it up and just be good at what you're doing. So, do not be like me complaining about sports. Do not be like me, like, I just want to have a cradle for my golf ball. That would be a lot easier, right? You cannot go home and say, well, I did good today. You can never claim it. I did good today in the golf course because I got the ball into the cradle. Or because there was no sand trap, there was no calm, there were no bushes. You cannot claim that you have reached your goal. Third point is, fix your eyes on the prize or the goal. Paul said, forgetting what is behind and straining what is ahead. The idea here of the word straining is straining what is ahead, is to lean forward to take hold of it, or to give this some kind of dedication or to be determination to get hold of what you're trying to get. The same idea that Paul uses in verse 16 when he persecuted the church. When he persecuted the church, he was determined to persecute the church before the Lord got hold of him. He was so determined. He pursued, and wherever he found Christians, he would go and arrest them and put them in jail. The same principle, the same idea that he said, to strain forward to get what is ahead of you. To lean forward with passion and vigor to get hold of the prize. Again, the idea here is to bring focus, to bring your entire being into focus to be hold of the prize. So, in other words, determination. You give everything, all the strength that you have to get to your goal. And there is one way to set your eyes on the prize. In sports, focus, the player's focus is a must. It is a must. Again, the golf and even basketball, but playing golf, I'm so amazed at how they play the game. I don't know how far is the hole of the ball. But before they take a swing at the ball, they will measure mentally. They will measure the distance between the ball and the hole. They will measure it. And then unconsciously, the player looks at the obstacles. And he's kind of like taking a picture of what are the obstacles and how far the ball from the hole. And then they'll position themselves, as we'll bring a golf club here today, like we'll get one. But they'll stand there and look at it, and they even sometimes they kind of line up the ball with a hole. And it was so amazing is that once they had all this information inside of them, it gives this information to the muscles, the leg muscles, the back muscles, and the arm muscles. And then when they hit the ball, it gives enough strength to put the ball closer to the hole and to avoid the obstacles, to avoid the center, to avoid the wall of time. That's giving or putting your entire body to focus on the goal. So see how amazing it is when you put focus on, you set your eyes on the prize or the goal. When they hit that ball, it gives the twist or enough strength to deliver the ball from one point closer to the hole. So that's bringing the entire body, and Paul said he disciplines himself to get to the goal or the prize. It's the same thing with playing the sport. When you're so focused on putting that ball to the goal or the prize, it involves your whole being. If there is no focus, if you don't set your eyes on the prize or the goal, you will hit the ball 2 miles away from the hole. But when you're so focused on setting your eyes on the prize, your entire being is involved. And with the goal to hit that ball, he will get closer to the goal. Let me close to this story. How many of you know Cliff Young? Anybody knows Cliff Young? I'm not talking about Cliff Young, the pastor. Not Pastor Cliff Young of our church in Bermuda. Cliff Young, can you see the picture? That's Cliff Young. Cliff Young was 61 years old, potato farmer and shepherd in Australia. Okay. In 1983, he showed up at the office of the marathon organizers in Sydney. Marathon is over 500 miles from Sydney to Melbourne or Melbourne. He showed up with his boots, rubber boots for work in the farm, and his overall. As he registered to run for the marathon, and as he told them that he wants to run the marathon, they did not want to believe him. Okay. Who wants to run a marathon, show up in rubber boots and overalls, 61 years old, and have no experience in running a marathon himself? But we give him a chance. Okay? We give him a chance. So, if you look at the, let me make sure that I have the right to the story here. Okay, so she was 61 years old, and he had to pick out his false teeth, because when he runs, it rattles. And the athletes there were trained. They were well short and whatever, they had the right shoes. But Chris Young had boots. And when they started running, he left him behind. Because, you know, athletes were trained. But he was asked, what is your experience when it comes to running a marathon? He said, oh, I chased the sheep around my farm and gathered them. And sometimes it takes me 3 days to gather them before the storm comes. But anyway, he was left behind. And they were making fun of him because of the way he ran. They call it, it's known as the Christian Shuffle. He was like that. He goes, he runs like that. Okay, there's a video. You can see this. You can Google it. And so, that was supposed to be how many days they were running a marathon. But Cliff Young made it first to Melbourne. The second person that arrived 10 hours later. So, what happened? The athletes that run the marathons were trained to run for 18 hours and sleep for 6 hours. Well, nobody told Cliff Young that. He just ran and ran and ran. You know, he only stopped for drinking and to eat. I never slept. He made it first. What is the point here? The point was that Clifton was to focus on getting to Melbourne. While the rest of the athletes were sleeping. When we are to focus on the goal and the path, we can get there regardless of how difficult it is. And Cliff Young became famous because he won the $10,000 prize. And he gave it all to the athletes that lost. We may be like Cliff Young, old or young, no experience, but when we set our eyes on the prize, on the goal, we can get there and have the victors we want. So don't be afraid to set goals for yourself. What are your goals? What are your spiritual goals? What is it that God wants you to do? What is it that God has called you to do? Just like the Apostle Paul, God has called him to be a preacher of the gospel. And he gave, you know, he gave everything that he got. I believe that we Paul said that he is already old and is ready. He this life. Because a sense of accomplishment. Because there was a goal, there was a call that he found. And he gave it his best. Rules did not matter to him. Because rules made him stronger. To make it to the finish line. The Bible tells us that when we cross the finish line, the Lord is waiting and saying, well done. Good and faithful servant. What are the goals that you set for yourself? Especially the spiritual goals. Goals for the call God has told us to do. Do not be afraid, even if your faith life just right. Just set your eyes on the prize. And you'll get there. And you'll get the victory of the Lord. Let's pray.